Breaking news into CNN, and it's just coming in from a White House official, says President Trump, his team is reevaluating an interview with Robert Mueller's team in light of the Cohen raid. This is from CNN's Jim Acosta. This is a White House official said the president and his legal team are reevaluating whether Trump should sit down for an interview with Mueller's team in light of the raid aimed at the president's personal attorney, Michael Cohen. The president has made no decision regarding the interview, but anybody with common sense will see the attack on his lawyer as cause to reevaluate, the official said. The official insisted the president's cooperation should be proportional to the courtesy he receives from the special counsel. The raid on Cohen's office is viewed as not showing the president that courtesy. So let's bring in now CNN political commentator David Swerdlick, assistant editor at The Washington Post, political analyst Michael Bender, who is White House reporter for The Wall Street Journal, and national security analyst Juliet Kayyem, a former official at the Department of Homeland Security. Good evening to all of you. Thank you so much. What do you think of this? Michael, you first, this new reporting.
Well, I think there's been a range of opinions within the Trump team for quite a while now on what to do about a potential interview with Mueller. And it doesn't surprise me that that some on the team are using the raid now to push forward a message that they may not go forward with an interview with Mueller. It does sound a lot like Trump. He likes to, that he would view this raid as discourteous and disrespectful, and want to reply in kind, which would be not to interview. I would caution, though, that as you said, there's no decision that has been made, and I wonder how long Trump can. I would imagine there's part of Trump that is eager to talk to Mueller and want to set the record straight right across the table from him.
Well, Juliet, even with that, I mean, will he be compelled to speak with Mueller whether he wants to or not?
I think the jury is out. I think Mueller would prefer that it not be the case. And it sounds like that was what they were hoping for until this reporting tonight, that this would be a voluntary discussion and that the contours of the discussion would be formed over time. And I think the challenge right now is the challenge all of us have, which is which Trump White House is speaking, not to undermine the reporting, but clearly people who don't want him to speak to Mueller have the upper hand right now because of what happened yesterday in Michael Cohen's office.
Again, the breaking news just into CNN is that a White House official is telling CNN's Jim Acosta that President Trump's team is reevaluating an interview with the special counsel Robert Mueller in light of the raid on his personal attorney's office and home yesterday. David, a source tells CNN that the news of the Cohen raid has angered the president beyond anything they have ever seen before. Do you think this is a real tipping point?
Yeah, it could be, Don. And in reaction to this news, I have two thoughts. One is that it sort of sounds like the president in other contexts, where if someone does something that he doesn't like, he wants to ratchet it up. China says, oh, we're going to answer your $50 billion in tariffs with $50 billion of our own. Then he answers it with $100 billion, and so it goes. Similarly here, oh, you raid my attorney's office. Maybe now I'm going to float the idea. If this reporting is, as Juliet says, coming directly from the president himself, then I raise you by saying maybe I won't talk to Bob Mueller after all. But the challenge, the political problem for President Trump here is that, as Bob Bennett said in one of your earlier segments, this is not how an innocent person acts when they're comfortable and want to clear their name. If he had no worries about what the results of this investigation, the special counsel's investigation, were, then it would behoove the president just to wait, talk to them, answer the questions. But because there's so much potential jeopardy, we don't know if the president has done anything that ran afoul of the law, but because there's so much jeopardy in terms of his story not matching up with other people that the special counsel has interviewed, I think he's got this problem of wanting to come clean and at the same time not wanting to trip himself up.
Well, Michael, also, you know, we have seen so much from the president in recent days of him wanting to take matters into his own hands, reports that he's not really paying attention to his advisors, but saying he's going to start doing what he wants to do, more of what he wants to do. Hope Hicks is gone, always kept him calm. Keith Schiller is gone, also his bag man gone. Who can keep the president calm now?
Well, I think you sort of alluded to it there, Don. I think the president has always pretty much done what he's wanted to do. But you raise a good point here on where the sort of checks and balances are, even within his own office. And I think it's right now, it's a real, we're at a real transition point in this White House. You mentioned Hope Hicks, Keith Schiller's been gone a while. Rob Porter, the staff secretary, who is dealing with some pretty serious personal issues right now, that is a position that hasn't been replaced. Tom Bossert, the Homeland Security advisor, who left today, he was well liked in the White House. He was organized. He was people described him as a perfectionist. There's no replacement for him. Meanwhile, the position that John Kelly has filled is a deputy chief of staff for policy coordination, Chris Liddell, who's mm-hmm. in charge of the Office of American Innovation. This is a position that's never really existed formally in the Trump White House. So I just wonder if we're at a point here where Kelly is maybe restructuring the White House here slowly but surely, and it'll be interesting to see where his next move is to fill some of the empty spots in this White House.
But there are reports, though, that from multiple reports that the chief of staff, John Kelly's authority is diminished. I mean, he hasn't been included in important conversations and policy decisions in executing recent staffing changes. I mean, he was considered one of the few, the so-called adults in the room. Does that make it even more likely that the president could make a rash decision? David, I'll give that to you.
Look, I think General Kelly has in part undermined himself. There was the episode with Congresswoman Frederica Wilson. There was the issue with Rob Porter, where, you know, he was not found to be fully forthcoming by a lot of reports. And that undermined his credibility publicly inside the White House. I think the pattern is set, whether it's General Kelly or others, that President Trump has a hard time in all circumstances taking the counsel even of the adults in the room. He's on his second Secretary of State, second press secretary, second chief of staff. So I don't know why General Kelly would feel secure that he could just go forward and lead the team without being under control.
And Juliet, his National Security Council reportedly rattled by Homeland Security Advisor Tom Bossert being pushed out by John Bolton. So you had that aspect of it as well.
Yeah, Thomas was well respected. He made some mistakes sometimes in the media, but as far as the agencies went, Tom was a really important figure, and that's, I think, really important to note here. All of these people are being paid by us, right? And there's so much drama, but we forget their actual job is to guide the agencies that are doing the real work. I've worked in federal government twice, once at the Department of Justice, once at the Department of Homeland Security, never worked in the White House. You look to the White House to give guidance when there was debates between agencies to sort of, you know, be the honest broker, to set communications plans, to help you elevate an issue if you had an issue that had to be elevated. None of that is being done. So while we focus on the White House, think of all these agencies and people within the agencies who are used to and actually do deserve a functioning White House. These, you know, but it's always about Trump, always ends up being about Trump.
Thank you all very much. I appreciate it.
Thanks, Don.